Hey icons, so it's another week of a video without me being in it because this is part two to last week's video where I'm going through more of the website builder options for you guys out there so you can build your online boutique. So again, this week, no intro, we're going to keep it quick. If you haven't seen the first part to this video, I'll have it linked down in the description below so that way you can go check out that video and see the rest of your options. But let's get right into the video. So the first one for this week is going to be Shopify, which I'm sure a lot of you all know about it already. So I'm just going to quickly scroll through some of the features. Again, it's another drag and drop website builder. But the one thing I always hear about Shopify is that it's really good for reports. So if you like to analyze your sales and your traffic on your website, I hear that Shopify is a good one to look at. I know a lot of people also use Shopify for drop shipping. Apparently, there's some apps on Shopify that you can connect to your website, which makes it easy as far as drop shipping. That's another feature I always hear about it. And then the other thing with Shopify is it connects with Instagram and it gives you features that other website builders won't give you. I know for a while the swipe up feature was only through Shopify. I don't think that's the case anymore, but that used to be the situation. But here I'm just going to go through some of the themes so that way you guys can see some of the layouts that you can choose from for your website. Just notice that a lot of these on Shopify, they're charging you for, and they're not cheap. Like $180, $160, those are expensive for templates. So keep that in mind when choosing Shopify. Some of the other website builders, they do not charge you for a majority of theirs. There's some that are premium layouts, I guess they would call it, and that you would have to pay for. But again, they're not $180. So just keep that in mind when working with Shopify. Because we're going to go into the pricing next. That way you guys can see what I was talking about in last week's video, how the pricing is a little more on Shopify than most. So here are the pricing plans. You can do your free trial. I want to say it's only 14 days. But then after that, they're going to start charging you. And you guys see that number there, $79 a month. To have an online store with Shopify. You're getting a lot for your money, but it is expensive. For someone that's just starting out, that may be too high to pay $79 a month. I was getting ready to say $75. But then here you see there's a $29 one that you can start with. You don't get all the features, but it may be just enough for you to at least get started. And then be able to work with Shopify. But you see some of the things you don't get, like you can't use gift cards. You don't get the advanced reports that people are always talking about. The shipping isn't automatically calculated, things like that. So just keep that in mind when looking at Shopify. So the next one is 3D Cart, which is another drag and drop website builder. You'll notice all of them are pretty much the same thing. The one difference I noticed with 3D Cart is that it connects with like Amazon, eBay, what were the other ones? Some other third-party websites that you can sell on. Google, Shopzilla, Facebook, there they are. So that would be helpful if you're selling on these other platforms so that way you can keep track of your inventory and not double sell on inventory that you have. And jumping right into the pricing here, you see a startup store is $19 a month. The good thing about this one, it's all listing them at no transaction fees, which is nice because most places, there is a transaction fee. I'm assuming when they say no transaction fees, they're referring to credit cards where they charge like that 2.9% per charge, per transaction, I should say. This one's saying none. So that's actually really good. You get to keep all of your money. I guess that's included in the price. And for $19 a month, that's pretty good. But from the $19 plan, it goes up to $29 and then $79 and $229. So definitely look at the feature differences, which I'm scrolling through right now. You may have to pause the video so you can take your notes and what you need to notate. but there's all the feature differences of the different price plans. Okay, so for number three out of the six that I have for you is webs.com. The only thing that I really know about this one, other than what I'm scrolling through right now, is the email address. I had a college professor that used to have a website on here just because it gave him a free email, and he liked that idea. Other than that, it's just another drag and drop website builder like the rest of them. You get your domain with it, the email, like I said. Basically, everything comes with it. It's just a matter of looking at templates and pricing just to see if this one is the right one for you. So we're going to go right into the pricing now. So jumping right into the pricing off the bat, I noticed that the pricing is a lot cheaper than some of the other ones. For $22, you get all the features here. I should say $22.99 to be exact. The $5.99 one, you don't get a store, so keep in mind when choosing that so you're not wasting money. But other than that, you see the emails are included there for webs.com. So I'm going through this fast, y'all, because I'm going to be doing a recap video on all of this anyway. But number four is Squarespace. And right off the bat, I love the layout and the look of Squarespace just going onto their website to learn about it. It looks so intricate and high tech. Like, this is something I definitely will want to build my website on, which actually I had looked into building a website on here, and I don't remember why I didn't. Maybe it was pricing. But they offer a lot of features. It looks really good. They have a lot of nice templates that you can play around with. Again, it's still a drag and drop website that you can use to create your website and your store. Nothing special compared to the other ones, but just coming on the website to begin with is a nice presentation for me to say, okay, I want to build my website here. But enough on the features. Let's go ahead and look at some of the templates on this one, which I haven't really shown you on any of the other ones. But let's see if the templates live up to the whole layout of their actual website. So they say they're the leader of design. Let's see if they really are. Here are some of the templates and the layouts that you can choose from, which so far they look good. But keep in mind, these layouts are using their pictures, not yours. When you're creating your website, you'll be using your own pictures. And I learned that too. I'll pick this layout that I love, and then I start putting my pictures in it, and it doesn't look the same. So just keep that in mind when you're choosing. And now for the pricing here that we all want to know. The basic is $26, which you can see everything that comes with it. Then it jumps up to $40. So a little cheaper than Shopify, but still up there. So that was Squarespace. Now we have Square Up, which is those little card readers that you can get for free. You can also build a free website for it, which I forgot. I actually did have a website with them before because it was an easy way to keep track of inventory and still be able to go out and take payments on the spot with the card reader. So you can see here, you could build a free website on here. They do have paid options if you want additional features, but you can do this completely free. So for those of you that are beginner and you're on a budget, this is definitely the way to go for you because it'll save you money, but you can still have some type of online presence. I think in order to have your own domain is when you have to start paying. Otherwise, you can use the free domain that they give you. But we're going to go straight into the pricing next so that way you guys can see what I'm talking about. So here it is for all the beginners on a budget. The basic plan is completely free. Then you're jumping up to $12 a month, up to $26 a month, $72 a month. So they do have plans that are up there. But there is a free option. Your website will even be secure and you get a little storage, not unlimited, but it's still enough. But like I said, you can't connect your own domain with the free plan. But if you start paying the $12 a month, that's when you can use your own domain. So you have to decide what you need for your business and what would work for you. This may be something if you just want to start by using social media to sell, but then give your customers a place to check out. This is the way to go because you can list your inventory on there and they can pay online. So it feels like a legit website. They just have to click the link from your Instagram. But here are the rest of the features that you get with each plan on SquareUp. Okay, last one, which is GoDaddy.com. You guys have heard me say that I use GoDaddy for a lot of my stuff, but I don't use it for a website. I've never used it for a website before. But just like one of the other ones, was it 3D Cart? You can connect these to other third-party platforms, so that way you can control your inventory between all platforms, which is a really good feature if you sell on more than just your website. That's the main thing that I noticed with GoDaddy compared to the other ones. Otherwise, it's another drag-and-drop website builder. And for the pricing of GoDaddy's website, ignore that $9.99 because that's not for an online store. If you want a store, it's $19.99 a month. And these are all the features that you would get with that pricing, which is a lot. That is a good amount of features for that price range. But just know that you're not paying $9.99. You're going to be paying $9. So that's it for this week's video. So between the two, this one and last week's video, I've given you a total of 10 different website builders. Sorry, I went through this one so quick. I literally squeezed 6 of them in the amount of time that I did 4 the last time. But they're all pretty much the same. It's just pricing that's different. Plus, I want to do an overall recap of the two videos next week. So be sure to check in next week for that video to see my opinion on each website builder. And just to hear an overall recap of everything that I talked about in these two videos to get a better understanding of everything. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button and click the bell so you get notified as soon as that recap is uploaded. Thank you for watching.